Hello photographers, welcome to my photography channel. Today in this awesome video, I'm going to show you how to use Silver FX Pro 3 because black and white photography is my favorite and I think this sort of software is amazing. So I've got a bunch of photographs ready. In this tutorial, I'm going to use something like cliff or mountain or something similar, more like a landscape, because I think that will give a really nice definition. So I'm going to drag and drop a photo here and immediately it put me on the side by side. So good thing about it that you can leave the neutral one on the left hand side and you can change the right one, see which one you like. For example, I can just change using preset the right hand side one. And I can see that, hey, maybe something is too much, something is too less. So you can decide which one you prefer the most. Generally in the landscape, I personally like the one, you know, a little bit contrasty, like is looking now. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to start from the neutral as both, close the window, and looking at the histogram, everything looks good if I use my cursor on each side. I can see exactly where my luminance is. So the histogram looking very good. Now that means that I don't need to do any kind of brightness, highlight, mid-tone, shadow changes because everything is just super neutral. What I'm going to do, add some dynamic brightness. So it will make some kind of brightness, add some brightness, but important part is that it will keep the black as black, which is amazing. Now in the contrast, this is where my game is. So I'm going to amplify black. So I'm going to put the slider up. You can clearly see that it started to look a little bit nice and beautiful, contrasty. This is exactly what you want. So I'm going to make it bigger. So now it looks good. And then later on, we're going to compare side by side. Now in a structure, maybe I can add some more structure so it gives a little bit oomph, a little bit amazing punch, which I love, and maybe a little bit fine structure. So far the photo looks already amazing, right? So I'm not going to spend too much time there. In the tonality, I'm going to add some more about 74 into the highlight so that it protects my highlight. Shadow, I'm not really worried about it. In the clear view, that's my another favorite. So it adds a little bit more punchy contrast there. And it's different than the structure because what it does, it's kind of adds some minor micro contrast. So let's check side by side right now. Check this one out. How wonderful is it? Anyway, moving on. Now in the landscape photography, you can add some, you know, color filter. So either you can keep neutral, red. So red filter is one of my favorite. What it does, it makes sure the sky is darker. But because you have a greenery, so you can add green filter or blue filter. Now blue filter, actually, I'm digging it. You know what I mean? So between the blue filter and the red, I'm confused because they both have a distinct character. Because in the blue, the greenery looks much more punchier, but in the edges here, it's bringing up a really nice brightness. Where in the red one, the sky is getting darker, so everything else becoming a bit more punchy and distinct. I'm gonna stick with blue, but because I like the foreground of the red filter, so I'm going to go to the blue, then select my control panel point, add some control point, and reduce, amplify whites there. There you go. And maybe one more control point in between. Amplify white. One more control point over here. And amplify white. And if you wanna know what is going on and where is happening, what you can do, you can click this little button next to the tick, and you can see exactly where you are applying the control points, which is pretty awesome. Now, so far looks good, but I also want to bring up the fountain there. So in order to bring up the fountain, I'm going to add another control point right there, make it smaller, pull it up, make sure I add amplify white as much as I can, but then again, amplify black too. So what is happening, it's showing you the fall, like a nice and beautiful fall all the way to the down. So I can maybe make it a little bit bigger, pull it down, and I can do a little verification if I'm applying to the right place. Yep, I'm applying exactly on the fountain. So that's amazing. And maybe I can add some brightness there. Add some fine structure. So far looks good, maybe a little bit black. Boom, that looks good. Right, so I'm going to close that window and let's compare side by side. Look at the neutral one and look at the one that we just done. Pretty amazing, isn't it? Now, once it's done, curve, you know, sincerely one of my favorite tool, but in this case, I don't want to make this video longer showing you how to use curve because this is probably one of the most used and important tool in photography history, in the digital one for that matter. And you should learn it. So just quick example, far right is the highlight and the white. So you can reduce or add white. Far left is the shadow or black. So you can either add black or you can reduce black. You know what? Maybe I'll do that and add some fade look. Hey, check this one out. I just made it look even more awesome. Ha! Oh, sometimes I love myself. Now, in the blue channel, in the sensitivity, I would like to make the sky even more dark. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to reduce the blue. Let's see if it gives me something. And reduce the cyan. There you go. Now the sky looks a lot darker, which I love. And in the green channel, I'm going to add brightness in my foliage. Also in the yellow, let's see what it does. There you go. It's giving a little bit awesome punchy look. Now I'm going to go back all the way up. Check my histogram. My histogram looks phenomenal. That's exactly what I was looking for. Now finally, film stock. What kind of film would I like? Do I add any kind of grain there or not? Actually, no. I'm just going to stick with the original because I like the look as it is. But if you want to add film grain, obviously you have a bunch of lists where sky is the limit. Now, finishing adjustment. Now, finishing adjustment, that what kind of tone would you like? Would you like some sepia look, like yellowish look or blue? In this particular photograph, I'm looking at cyan. So I'm going to add the silver hue to cyan and add a touch silver toning. Started to look nice, maybe a bit more. So I'm going to show you before and after. Extraordinary. And the balance, I'm good at the balance. Maybe I will reduce the balance a little bit so that, sorry, that direction. Now it looks much better. The paper hue, maybe a little bit orange. So add some paper toning. So far looking even better. Should I add some vignette? Question is that I don't want any vignette because I want everything corner to corner looks beautiful. So I don't want to add any kind of vignette. So I'm just going to close it. Burn edges, not far from the vignette anyway. It emulate back in the day when we used to enlarge a photo, you know, sometimes there was a minor imperfection. This is what it is. Again, I'm not a big fan personally, so I'm not going to add it. Same with the image border. So you can add many image border. For the sake of this tutorial, I am going to add one that looks all right, I guess. And this is the end of tutorial. So you can actually go to the file and save image. Now, this is my friend, how you use SilverFX Pro. I hope you like this tutorial. If so, please like and subscribe. And I see you in future video. Look after yourself. Bye-bye.